Hey, what is going on, guys? Thank you for clicking on the video. Shout out to all the lefties out there. They say that left-handed people are supposed to be smarter. I guess Einstein and all these other geniuses out there were lefties. I don't really think that I fit that mold very well, but hey, I'll take it. I want to start the video with a quick tip that I learned from one of the leaders of my company, and ever since I've been implementing, it's really helped me out a lot. So this is called the 2-minute rule, and really all that it says is if you have a task that takes 2 minutes or less, you have to do it right then. You can't put it off, you don't put it on a to-do list, you just knock it out because it takes 2 minutes, right? But what happens is if you have these tasks that you do put off for later, one, you waste time putting them on a to-do list because it'll probably take 30 seconds just to write that out, you know? And then you also can get rid of some of that clutter in your brain. You know how you always have these things that you know you have to do in the back of your head? Well, that gets rid of a lot of that. So maybe you have a quick email you can knock out or just something really quick you have to put away. And you know, all these things you say I'll do later, but if you just do it right then, knock it out, I promise you it gets a lot easier. And then you can really save your energy for those bigger tasks. So I figured I'd leave you guys with that. On to the video. Insert the joke about things that take less than 2 minutes here. You know how it always feels like you're juggling a million different things at once, and then we complain about it, like, if I could just get rid of some of this stuff, but I always think about, well, what's the alternative, you know? Like, what if I wasn't juggling all this stuff? What would I do? I would go out and find more stuff to juggle, so.
Whoa, only know you've been high when you're feeling low. Only hit the road when you're missing home. You only know you love it when you let it go. But you let it go. Look, see, I remember when I met you as a sophomore. Started out as friends, but I knew that we would want more.
Dang, this thing is looking clean, man. I like it. What do you guys think? I'm sure most of you are very happy with this over the Ridgeline. It's actually a real truck, I know, but it's like driving a tank. You know, with so much hate in the world, I feel like we should talk about love more. So let's just take a few minutes to talk about things that we love. For me, I love sunshine. Probably more than 99% of things on this earth. I love Brussels sprouts, Halo Top. I love never having to worry if I'm doing or saying something wrong because the internet will always tell me about it. Never Lifts Nathan will leave a comment down below if I'm doing an exercise wrong. The spelling teacher will tell me if I spell something wrong on Twitter. All these things, you know, the internet lets me know. I never have to do any research for myself. I love sports. Some sports because they intrigue me. I always wanted to be like MJ back in the day. Then I wanted to be like White Iverson, and now I'm just like not any type of athlete whatsoever, but that's okay. And other times I like sports because like on Sunday afternoons when everyone's out watching the Bengals game, there's nobody here at the gym. I don't care about the Bengals, so it's all good with me. What else, man? I love you guys, of course. I love, man. That's just, no. Cut that one out. All right, I'm just gonna shut up now, but someone left me a message on, I think it was Facebook or Instagram. Someone sent me a DM and asked if I could go over my fitness goals. I thought that was a pretty good question. So really, you guys know that my goals have kind of shifted because I can't really get back into powerlifting, at least the way that I would want to. So instead of strength, I've been focusing on gaining size, gaining some weight, and I really want to get up to like 180 pounds without getting too fat. Now, obviously, for me, I could get up to 180 by next week, no problem. I could just eat my face off, but that's not really the kind of weight that I'm looking to gain. So I'm at about 173 pounds right now. If I could get up to about 180, 181 in the next 6 or 7 months, I think that'd be good with me. And then I'll go on a cut and show you guys all the rock hard muscle that I put on. All right, I can't even take myself seriously. You know, I think the only thing more awkward than doing bicep curls in the gym while recording yourself is another guy in the background doing bicep curls while recording yourself. I don't know why, but I see every soccer mom doing this exercise, but you know what? I am the most jacked soccer mom there is. Just kidding, that kills my shoulder. Really, really good workout. One of the best I've had in a while, and I think it's because I didn't answer any text messages, didn't check any YouTube comments, didn't check my Instagram, none of that. And it makes a big difference. So now I'm done, I can go back to trying to be social media famous and all that, but I feel like I needed to do a better job of, when I'm in the gym, just freaking train, man. So there's this place called Wings and Rings that some people say is better than BW3s. Kind of have a hard time believing that. Sounds like marketing to me. And I'm always a little bit skeptical when you have these places that come up after like the OGs, like everyone that tried to copy Chipotle, and now everyone's trying to copy Blaze Pizza. But I feel like there's only one way to really find out.
Man, I keep my head so
high. That last drone shot, no bueno, man. I was so rushed. People have not been very nice about the drone lately. They don't like it, and I get it, right? Who wants this thing flying around? You don't know what I'm using it for, but I gotta get the shot. Okay, so now what 90% of you clicked on the video for, how does the food compare? Well, we'll find out. Let's see. I mean, I would say BW3's has some of the best celery sticks that I've personally ever... That's some fresh celery. I don't know, man. Celery, I'm gonna have to think about that. But the broccoli, there's gotta be a clear, decided winner. Not gonna lie to you guys. I've gotta give it to Wings and Rings. They're broccoli. I mean, I don't think BW3's has broccoli, but if they did, I bet this would be better. Come on, you guys know I can't eat the good food before it gets cold. That would be against everything this channel stands for. But this does look amazing. I'm gonna try to set this up the same way I set up the B-Dubs thumbnail back in the day. The struggle of my life. Okay, how did I do? It's been a process. It's been like an hour since I talked to you last.
Ghost, man, I keep my head so high. Even though they try to bring me low. And now all of those same people calling my name. It's kind of...
All right, so we have some teriyaki bonus wings. We also have some grilled wings with some Cajun seasoning. We have this steak sandwich, which looks phenomenal. And we have some onion rings, just because I felt like you can't go to Wings and Rings without getting them. But I'm gonna start here with the grilled wings. I would compare these to B-Dub's Naked Tenders, I think they're called. And then this just has like a dry rub. It definitely tastes very healthy. Like if that's what you're going for, I guarantee the macros on these are pretty good. Kind of dry just because it's grilled and it's not fried. I would say, I think B-Dub's Naked Tenders actually have more flavor than this, but this is not bad at all. It's still better than the chicken that I make in my kitchen. All right, so up next we have the teriyaki boneless wing, just I guess the normal food that these restaurants are known for. So really, it's good, but it tastes like any other wing that you would throw in a deep fryer and throw sauce on top of. I mean, it's all right, but I wouldn't say that it's any better than B-Dub's, but I don't know that I can really say. I don't know though. I feel like B-Dub's probably, at least in my mind, this could be biased because I've just been eating B-Dub's for years. I feel like it's a little better, but this is perfectly fine. On to what I'm mostly excited about. Look at this steak sandwich. I feel like you guys deserve a slow-mo bite for this one.
You can either hate it or love it, but bruh, it's all up to you. Now I can settle down for real and go and stock up on suits, but that ain't happiness to me, and I can't stop the pursuit.
Honestly, I think I like this the best. I don't think I've had anything like this at B-Dub's, but B-Dub's does have good food other than the wings as well, so I guess that's gonna be kind of like a tie. Okay, so last and certainly least, I just felt like I had to get these onion rings. Not a fan. I just don't like onion rings. They remind me of Burger King for some reason. Just, I don't know. They're all right. So my review of Wings and Rings is good. Not as good as B-Dub's, but still good. I suck at food reviews. I think everything's good. This is why I'm so uninterested in food reviews. Because I'm like, you don't know me, bro. You don't know what I like. But yeah, if you guys want me to do more food reviews, let me know down below. I feel like I don't add that much insight. I've seen some where people go into like all these details. I'm just like, how do you do it? Like to me, food is just like, food, I don't know, but you know what I'm really excited about? Well, I guess I'm not even gonna be able to make it. I've been craving a peanut butter and jelly and banana sandwich for the longest time, but I don't have peanut butter and I don't have jelly. And I can't tear apart my kitchen because it's gotta stay clean and all that, so I'm gonna try to I'm gonna try to make a sandwich without peanut butter and jelly that's gonna replicate a peanut butter and jelly without making a mess. Okay, so what do we have? We have peanut butter cookie protein powder. We have a 30% link in description. We have bread. We have a banana. So this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna mix up the protein, make a little bit like sludge. So here's what's gonna happen next. We're gonna make a triple decker sandwich, but here's a pro tip for you. Put one of the pieces in the toaster. We're gonna use this as the middle piece. So then you have the soft bread on the outside with the crunch on the inside. Just try it out. Man, I should have used one of the chocolate proteins because then the color would have contrasted with the bread. It would have looked better, but first world problems. You know how sometimes you crave something for a long time, then you'll have it, and it's kind of disappointing? This is not one of those instances. This is so good. You know, this is a really great couch. I don't know why I never actually sat on this before. All right, rich homies, I think we've done enough damage for the night, so we're gonna keep dessert pretty light here. We're gonna make a macro-friendly ice cream cake, and you're never gonna believe what we do. We take angel food cake, which is fat-free, we throw some Halo Top on top, yeah. And there you go, you got ice cream cake. I'm a freaking chef over here, man.
That's pretty pathetic. I'm not important yet.
Not gonna lie, I forgot about you guys, but I wanna end the video, say bye. Thank you so much for taking time out of your day to watch. You could've been doing anything in the entire world, and you chose to spend a few minutes with me. That's pretty awesome. Please give the video a like if you enjoyed it. It helps me out a lot. You guys are awesome, you're amazing. Have an amazing week, an amazing day. I'm delusional, see you guys next time.